goodness. When you are this early in a match like this, you want to knock out your opponent as quickly as possible and get that little respite. But the last thing you want is multiple men in this match, because then it is just a wild, wild west.
You know, that's almost a better name than a Rumble match, the Wild Wild West match. I kind of like that.
Since we're in Vegas and we're west, this is the Wild Wild West match!
Maybe we can hit. Oh, man! Matt Vandegrift never saw a risk he didn't want to take. He takes his chances, and you're taking your chances, and we're about to have a third man enter.
Clock here with 4, 3, 2, 1. Who is next?
Who's the third man? It's Wise Guy.
Wise Guy's coming out next.
Our main number 3, Wise Guy.
Wise Guy is one of those guys who has been doing his best to try and get that big win in FSW to move himself up the ladder of success. To get to the top.
Oh, wow.
What a single leg lariat.
And look at Wise Guy. Look like he's cut out of granite. He's the prototypical wrestler, and he's a high flyer and a strength guy at the same time.
There's not a thing Wise Guy can't do. That's what makes him so dangerous. But as I mentioned, he still needs that big FSW win, and this could be it tonight, but he's going to have to survive 29 other people. 27 left to go.
Vandegrift is on the apron. He's on the apron, but no, not to the floor. Just on the apron.
Going to this match, having already wrestled, having injuries, you have to wait for this reward. You get a title shot if you win.
And that's what it's all about, because you never know if you can ever qualify for a title shot. If you get yourself and have an opportunity to get a shot at a title, you take it.
In most cases, you got to win 6-7 matches in a row.
Right here, Jordan Cruz is trying to get Nino Black out, but Nino fighting.
Nino Black's always been a fighter. He fights for what he believes in.
Oh, he turned inside out.
Yeah, I believe he got turned inside out. Matches like this, you mentioned, are so dangerous, especially now there's five people in the ring.
Well, and the ring is going to fill up, so you want to try to eliminate people right now. We have another competitor coming down right now.
Sinister number six. And this is sinister in my mind.
Hard to the mid number six. Action Braxton.
The crowd does not like Action Braxton.
More than the crowd doesn't like him. Can you like this man?
I like his intensity, I like his fight, I don't like how, what he stands for.
He does have some positives, you're right, as far as his ability, as far as the way he's able to manipulate people, do things he wants. But his attitude, his personality, just drags him down.
You see, right now the ring is filling up. There's nobody been looking at in this match yet. So now we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 competitors right now in the ring. This ring is full, and a punch can come from anywhere, anytime, from any direction.
Punches define your path to victory at this point. There's so many obstacles, so many people looking for the same thing as you, looking for the same quest to win. It's hard, man. You got to overcome a lot.
This is the hard part of Battle Royals. This is the hard part. Look, 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 hold on. And we got another competitor coming in the ring.
Oh, here comes Danny
Lyon. Danny Lyon, light it up.
A member of Team Filthy. He has had incredible showings against men like
Nice.
Tequila Sunrise Super.
Elimination! Oh, no! Wow!
Running Spanish Fly, there's Action Braxton, Danny Limelight. He brought it up. He has an incredible opportunity tomorrow against Ice Williams for the No Limit title.
Limelight is turning up the volume here and is really making his presence known.
But if he can win this matchup, he'll also be taking Hammerstone.
Look! Oh, no! Vinegar! Frankensteiner! Kick out! Oh, my goodness! Scissors now. Oh my God! Oh my God!
A destroyer out of Danny Limelight, who could be challenging for two titles tomorrow. Member of Team Filthy. He's been on New Japan Strong. He has been on AEW. He's faced off with men like Jon Moxley. He is really a man that is breaking out in 2021.
Oh, a pedigree. Who's next? Who's next?
Our tournament number 8, Judah Matthews.
Not my Jesus, being accompanied to the ring by Primo Popo.
The Kraken, the Latin Kraken.
Yeah, I mean, I see the men he leads to the rings. I wonder if that's what he's giving them, crack, because of the way they act. But Judah Matthews, he is a tall powerhouse, and size has always favored bigger men in these type of matches.
Yeah, definitely size matters because it is hard to get a big man over the top ropes. So when you've got a guy who stands 6'6", like Judas, you really got to try to work hard to get him out. And in the ring right now, there's a bunch of bodies laying around. Only one man's been eliminated so far. And here we go.
Danny Limelight in trouble.
Oh, Limelight, no. He's skinning the cat.
But he walks right into Vandegrift, the man he destroyed, gave a destroyer to earlier in this matchup.
He's skinning the cat again. Limelight's skinning the cat again.
Well, he's only got 7 more cat skins left in before he's eliminated.
Well, yeah, you've only got 9 lives, so 2 of them are gone.
Oh, Vandegrift.
And Vandegrift skins the cat.
super kick. We get 8 seconds from the next competitor. So far, so everyone right now is in contention to become the number one contender.
Yeah, the chance here is good for anyone in this match. As anyone else, you gotta figure, man, like Nino Black, he's gotta be tiring, drawing number one, take advantage of him.
A lot
of action.
This oh, one. Jumping knee.
Yeah, wise guy. It's that drop kick. It's
oh, we get it. We got eliminated.
And together.
Limelight is showing me something here.
Man, he's one of the hottest prospects in wrestling.
Here we go, another competitor.
Fumble. Yeah, lay down and die. Oh no, not I. I will survive.
Did Jim Mitchell teach him that?
I plead the fifth.
The songbird of professional wrestling, looking to soar, looking to fly high tonight in this rumble. Can you imagine if night two of our 12th anniversary is headlined by Ricky Sinatius and Hammerstone for the FSW?
Can you imagine that?
Despite all his improvements, he's still one of the least liked wrestlers in the FSW fan.
I think the singing
is it is. It's like 89% of them. The other 11 is the rest of us. In a match like this, is there ever a point where you're like, I think I want to take a risk? Just to try and eliminate someone.
Look,
it, or is it all safe?
It is all safe because it only takes a second to eliminate. All you gotta do is just be distracted by 1 second.
It's all hedging your bets on this match?
That's it. Here we go. Another competitor is coming in right now.
Well, who's next? The master of the Iron Claw. Haven't seen one more devastating since Von Raschke.
Look at this. The crowd is electric right now.
One in the ring. I don't know if the camera's caught it. Lights, camera, faction. Just double-teamed Danny Limelight. The man that will be taking on their stablemate tomorrow for the No Limits title.
And this ring is full of people. There's a claw! There's a claw!
The claw, baby! Vocal cords with it. In the ring once again, Braxton Fresco targeting Danny Limelight. Danny Limelight's got a date with the No Limits champion, a member of Ice Camera Faction tomorrow.
Through the second and third rope doesn't count. You gotta go over the top rope and eliminate.
Yeah, you gotta go up and over, which Braxton went up. Oh! Caught Fresco
in
Fresco with the drop kick.
Action Braxton is gone.
Caught Fresco with the drop kick. Caught Braxton with the gutter.
Oh! not looking better. 5 seconds away.
I'd say the hurt's thinning, but it's really not. It's still not. To get Watson in the ring, clearly giving him instructions to kick out Limelight. What the hell? Like the other members of Light's camera back. Light's camera back and the other two members, Fresco and Braxton, the men we thought were eliminated or were eliminated, came back in eliminated Limelight. I'm not sure why that's ever allowed.
The crowd is behind.
Dave Mazzani, the paint train.
And we're 9 seconds away. Here we go. Next competitor coming in.
The intensity of Mazzani.
Who we got? West Coast mainstay. He has been all over California. He is a 6'6" man who is just intense. Look at his eyes.
It looks like we're gonna have a horse fight between the two biggest in this match.
Oh!
Good Lord!
Oh my God!
Prayer won't save you now.
Eric Watt showing he's got what it takes now. Look at this.
Yeah, but look at Wise Guy. He's got that low center of gravity. I can actually help you out in a match like this. Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
What a display of strength from Watts. I can definitely see him being trouble for Hammerstone should he win this one tonight. He's been dominant in a short time in the ring.
Guy like Watts, look at that! That is a guy Hammerstone wants nothing to do with.
I don't think anything wants anything to do with him. It's a great time to grab this number to bring into this match. A battle royal.
Here we go, next competitor. 5 seconds away.
FSW, because one day he wants to hold that belt, the FSW championship, but he can get a fast pass to the top if he can overcome the men in this matchup and challenge tomorrow night.
It's all my time.
Hammerstone mentioned that he felt disrespected by some of the competitors in this match, given some of the words they had headed into it. Combo out of Xander.
Right now, look, literally everybody's going crazy right now because this match is important.
Oh, cuts him in half with the spear. Watson. The last hope for Light's camera faction.
And look at Eric Watts. This man killing people. Uh-oh.
Look at Ricky Tenacious.
Tenacious got caught. Called the timber right there.
A timber.
It's timber because you're laying down a stack of wood.
Lumberjack slam. Well, right now we're gonna have another man entering.
Here we go. 3 seconds.
Brandon G.
Here we go.
Number 15, Brandon G.
published author, Brandon G, in the Book of Greatness.
Brandon G looks to get in and take his claim to the number one contendership for the SFW title.
And this might be the biggest upset, at least of who's in the ring at the moment. Brandon G. Greatness.
Well, Tenacious is in the corner. Oh!
No!
Cut him in half.
Vito Black over the shoulder. Tenacious, but Tenacious slides out. Tenacious tries to eliminate Black.
Oh, Tenacious is... No, hold on. Tenacious is done. Tenacious is out.
Ricky Tenacious drops off the charts. No longer in this rumble.
Going for the, I see a reverse claw here. No.
You see Sanders' fingers being bent up on Nazani. You see Black's first time showing any kind of weakness in this matchup, or at least that was momentary. When he was in the corner with Nico Black.
There are bodies everywhere here, 8 seconds away from the next competitor coming in.
See, the wrath of this rumble is taking its toll on everybody here. What are you going to feel like tomorrow if you challenge Hammerstone?
Brett
the Threat is coming out and he's taking his time. Look at him.
The self-proclaimed 2021 FSW Rookie of the Year. He has some harsh words for Nick Zander. These two have been at each other's throats for months now. Who the true Rookie of the Year will be?
Well, he's trying to say he's coming to him. You know, he's going to buy it, winning this battle royal and going on to become the number one contender.
He's FSW's version of a Paul brother. Combined, he is more annoying than both Logan and Jake combined.
Full of bodies going at it. Once again, let me reiterate, it is probably 100 degrees inside this building. And then when you put a mass of people together, it is probably 120 degrees in that room and under those lights.
And look at that, Sander and Brett the Threat facing off. That rivalry continues, and that's why you don't disrespect Dave Mazzani.
There he is.
Well, that's not going to help his Rookie of the Year hopes. Brett the Threat, he can't make friends anywhere.
I'll keep my eye on the clock. I'm wondering when the next competitor is coming down.
Yeah, Brett the Threat, he pissed off, you know, one of Madison's members, Rocky T. Rocky T brought his whole Wild Hogs Motorcycle Club with him. They took care of Brett the Threat. Brett the Threat should have just kept his mouth shut.
Look at this right now. Everybody's going to there's got to be 10 men in the ring right now. Yes.
Oh, yeah. And what do you feel like the next day? You're going to challenge Hammerstone.
You go home and try to recover. Seconds away for next competitor.
Who's going to be? What?
Strella? What?
We were told 30 man rumble.
Number 17, Strella.
But we know Strella has never backed down from a fight.
Strella just don't care.
In fact, she picks them for her own entertainment. She is bougie, she is bad, and she is thick. And she might be challenging Hammerstone for the FSW heavyweight title tomorrow.
Can you imagine that if Strella wins? Can you imagine that?
I can't imagine it, but I'm starting to think about it. I'm really liking her odds.
Oh, man.
Built like a brick thick house, Strella.
A brick thick house.
Oh! That was
Strella
bougie.
Strella just don't care. Look at her. That's one bougie biatch.
And her rivalry with Brandon Greatness continues. Nick Xander. We saw Estrella get involved in the championship match earlier tonight.
Nick Estrella going right at him. Hammering clubs. And we're 9 seconds away. 8, 7, 6. Here we go. Next competitor coming out.
Going on for more than 20 minutes now.
These dirty in every way.
The freshest man is not this, and he walks right into a fight with Dave Mazzani. This is a bad idea. Mazzani, a former cage fighter, manipulate every joint, break every bone.
That partner and walk with him. Oh! 10 seconds of this better. Ring is full of individuals.
going right after Strel. For all we know, she could have angered him at some point. Some locker room issues. I'm sure a lot of people are glad she's in this match.
Give her credit. She's competed a long time.
Yeah, that's her last match. Considering all the drinks you had tonight, now you know how Sandman would have was the man he defeated in that four-way. Nino Black is still in the ring of Survivor.
Right now, look, I'm trying to catch my breath.
I know.
I've seen this before. But he's still blown up.
Speaking of blown up, imagine Nino Black back now.
Like, who is going to win this?
Belly to belly.
Come on, let's go!
Tony Nunez is looking for a fight. Look at Vander Graaf gets caught.
Oh, look at that.
Swat him around, release Hiranagi.
You can hear the crowd settling in right now because they want to know how this is going to end, what is going to go on.
Yeah, how is this going to play out? What twist and turns are there going to be?
Oh, look, right through the clothesline. Oh, God!
He had checked the mouth. And rather get hit by a train. Yeah.
What's Stella doing?
What a interesting picture this is. Why? Why would you pick this fight?
And Stella is literally outmanned. Tag team partners.
I know you can't disqualify a guy, especially once he's been eliminated in general.
Yeah, but that's taking too much.
Yeah, we have referees and officials out there to separate and stop situations like this.
And look, the action you're really stopped right now is when a black is getting beat on the floor.
Well, once Dino gets back in the ring, he's going to use the tickets. And all of them want to know how easy this thing is.
Oh, God.
Another discus lariat. Visually, too. The brawl on the bottom, the brawl, the slaughter on the outside.
Literally, the action in the ring is coming to a stop.
And Matt Vandegrift has been in there. Oh, damn it.
Final four!
Good. His mic doesn't work.
One of these men will become the number one contender for the FSW Heavyweight Championship tomorrow night at Day 2.
And which man will it be? Look at this, Vandegrift and Hero Lou realize they gotta work together.
And look at EC3 just backing off and letting everybody else do the dirty work.
As big as Hero Lou is, Juicy is even larger. And EC3 is gonna work together with him now.
Uh-oh.
Hammerstone's Bitcoin is cashed.
mission. I talked to FSW's board of directors.
Triple threat tomorrow night with FSW Heavyweight Champion.